Norma Norma Norms. Norma 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 Norms. What's up all you cool snakes and neonates, how's it going? I hope you're all keeping well. So today we have a spider special for you. Again, we're sort of rotating between spiders and snakes these days. We've got spider one, the snake one, spider one, snake one. It's just how it's happening. So, you guys know I've been waiting for that Nandu Drapepe, that big Brazilian giant blonde bird eater molting out. Well, it finally molted out. So take a look at this quick molting montage. See those white fangs? Now look at those fangs right there. Get a good view of those fangs. So those fangs are soft. This whole spider right now is extremely soft. It's very vulnerable. That shell is not hardened. The fangs should be black. So, well, this is very good. He's doing well. I just need those pedipalps to pop out there. If this is male, I would imagine this would be the maturing molt. There we go, our Jacob molted out. Now, you guys know, I was hell-bent on it being a female. Didn't turn out to be female, it turned out to be male. And that was his maturing molt. Matured into a male. He had all his pedipalps, which means that he was ready for breeding. I don't have a female Trapepe here with me at all. So, it would have went to waste. So, we rehomed him.
You're so pretty, Jacob.
Bonus reptile rich points if you can tell me what other YouTuber our male Nandu Trapepe went to. And I'll give you another hint, we also sent off our mature male Brazilian red and white. If you guys can tell me what YouTube channel those two spiders went to. Bonus reptile rich points for you. Hit me up in the comments below. Tell me where they went. Next, we are going to rehouse our Martinique pink toe. The reason I want to rehome this spider, can you guys hear that cricket? Shut up! Crazy! Those males are going crazy back there, those crickets. So, that's what happens when you feed them and water them. So, we are going to rehouse our Martinique pink toe. It's getting a bit big for its enclosure. It webs up the top, so you've got the lid there, it webs up to there, and what happens every time I open it up, it jumps out because they're really good at jumping, and it runs, makes a run for it. So we're going to put it into a bigger enclosure because it's obviously trying to get higher and higher. So we're going to put it into a bigger enclosure now. Same style enclosure. It's going to be one of these enclosures here. Now these enclosures we got off Amazon, we don't buy them anymore because they aren't actually that fantastic. They're fine for, you know, growing on slings and things like that, but they don't hold in humidity at all. There's too much ventilation in them, which is fine for the Martinique pink toe because they like a bit of ventilation, but they let all the moisture out and it's just crazy. So what I've done here, as you guys can see here, is I've siliconed the bottom of this enclosure so that all the water and moisture doesn't just go straight through the soil and straight out the bottom, which is what happens on a regular basis with these enclosures. So hopefully siliconing the bottom of this is going to help lock the moisture in a bit better. So we're going to pop this Martinique pink toe in here and hope that it behaves a little bit better, because it's one heck of a mischievous spider, that's for sure. It's a little rascal, that one. So let's go and rehome it. So the Carabina versicolor or Martinique pink toe, they like an arboreal setup. So we've got the twigs in there because, as you can see, it likes to make a web, so I thought I'd put the twigs in there to give it anchor points for its web. It's got that sort of half tunnel bit of cork bark in there to climb up and web around if it wants. Water bowl's up high this time because I put the water bowl on the floor in that one. And yeah, as you can see, it's not very easy to get to. Look at that pretty spider right there. Looking a little on the thin side with that abdomen. We get a nice meal in it as soon as we get it in there. But that's a gorgeous spider. But yeah, you can see it's they like a good bit of space, whereas a lot of spiders you could get away with. This was probably most other spiders. I would still keep it in here for maybe one or two more molts. But this spider seems to like a bit of space, so we're going to pop it into the bigger enclosure now and let it web up to its heart's content. Give me a minute there, little spider. So we'll get some water in that bowl and get that ready. Now, the reason for that water bowl being there is I don't have to fully open it up to put the water in. So, got my trusty paintbrush, my soft paintbrush, and my catch cup here, just in case this little rascal decides it wants to go run around. Let's see how we get on here. It's hungry. Attack the paintbrush here. Stop attacking the paintbrush. Now, usually you want out of here. There you go, little one. Boom. Into its new enclosure. There we go. Look at that spider right there. Ooh. That is gorgeous. One of few spiders that are actually stunning from the sling stage, so from hatching. They're born this beautiful blue colour, and they are just beautiful. You're going to go down just a little bit. Still wanting food. Should we try and feed this straight away, guys? Let's see if we can feed this little guy. I wonder if it could manage a larger, a smaller of the medium crickets. I reckon it could. This one has always managed larger prey items. Don't do it, little spider. I'm watching you while I'm wrestling with crickets. Why are you webbing the outside of the enclosure? You silly spider. Let me find you some lunch first. Look at that for a takedown. Beautiful. Right, don't do a happy dance outside the enclosure, please. Right. Can we get you to move up and in? Or will we just let you feed like that just now? Come on. It's actually doing a happy dance. I'm webbing the outside of the enclosure. You are a silly spider. Well, actually, I'm probably a silly keeper for even attempting this. But there we go. Look, we're getting a happy dance. Happy dance, happy dance. Happy dance, happy dance. Yeah, happy dance. That's the biggest cricket you've ever had, buddy. That's a smaller of a sort of size 3 cricket there. You really can't eat it there, but I really don't want to interrupt your little happy dance. Houston, we have a problem. Right, I'm going to try and move you up.
Don't eat the paintbrush. You have a full-size cricket in your mouth. Over the top. Over the top. Into your enclosure. There you go, buddy. Down and in. Down and in. There we go. Perfect. Beautiful. Spider handling Dave's beast, little beasties would be proud of right there. Probably not. But look at that. Never fails to eat that spider. It is fantastic. Apparently quite a difficult spider to keep alive. I basically just treat it like any other spider. Gets water when it needs it. It's fed when it needs it. The only thing I would say that we do with this spider is probably give it a little bit more space than the other spiders, and that's about it. It thrived in the smaller version of this. So we figured while it was still in sort of juvenile stage, which is the crucial stage when people tend to lose them, we would put it in something similar, just because we know that it's thriving and surviving in that. Like I say, you can see there that the bottoms of that wasn't... I'll show you right now. So the base of that is not sealed, and look at it just coming straight out the bottom. So you can see there, it's just useless. So it lets all the water right out the bottom. So that's why we sealed it up with the HA6 silicon sealer there. That's actually been sealed for a very long time. It doesn't look a hell of a pretty, but it's definitely going to be functional. And that enclosure is not supposed to be very pretty anyway. It's just a halfway house. It's just the next house. Probably the house after that will be its permanent house. There we go. Pretty happy spider, full of food. It's webbed the cricket to the side of the enclosure. How are you going to get it when it's under all that web? I know that's a big cricket, but... doing. Actually webbed over the top of it. Beautiful spider though. I could watch this one for hours. Especially now that it's in an enclosure where I can see it. I couldn't see it at all in the old enclosure. Beautiful. Now you've grabbed it and you've ripped it out the web. You see those spinnerets though? They're those extra appendages on the end of the abdomen. It looks like butt fingers. That is what it puts the web down with. So that's what it lays its web down with when it's putting its web down. Beautiful.
One happy little spider. So guys, as always, thank you very much for tuning in. If you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. We've passed that 800 subscribers. We're on our way to 1,000. So thank you very much for tuning in. As always, like, subscribe, comment, hit the bell button, share the channel around, all that good stuff, guys. Thank you very much for tuning in. Take it easy. Peace.